Democratic presidential candidate Hillary Clinton was met with crowds of supporters as well as protests over her foreign policy and criminal justice record at a campaign event in Baltimore on Sunday, April 10th.
A long one. The midterms, from time to time, and an occasional detour. And we know, in fact, the detour.
The event comes a day after she lost another matchup in Wyoming to streaking Vermont Senator Bernie Sanders. The next major primary is in New York on April 19th, and Maryland's primary is on April 26th, along with several other key states.
I will do everything in my power to break down every barrier that stands in the way of any American getting in. We want to pay attention to our cities like Baltimore. I have put forward a very comprehensive agenda about how we're going to make these investments grow businesses and jobs.
Clinton has been endorsed by dozens of Democratic elected officials in Maryland, including Senator Ben Cardin, Senator Bubba Mikulski, and Rep. Elijah Cummings. Another group was kicked out, they said, after they took issue of Clinton's use of the word super predators to support the 1994 crime bill.
Is by changing this development that we're in.
We spoke to several attendees about why they support Hillary Clinton.
She'll be able to help the lower class as well. You know, black people believe that, you know, she's been in the political for a long time, you know, Bill Clinton, so.
You know, one of Bernie Sanders' messages is that Clinton is too close to Wall Street and that she doesn't have, like, poor people's interests at heart. She's more for corporate profits. How do you respond to arguments like that?
No, I think that's false. I think, you know, she's for lower class. You know, I think that as far as a lot of other presidents, you know, she's a supporter of Obama as well. And I think that a lot of the people that's, you know, in the politics now is hurting, you know, what Obama's been trying to do for the last 8 years. You know, Hillary's been there to support. Even though she ran in 2008, she's still there to support him as well. So
she has a lifetime of proven leadership and work on issues that are important to me. So that sets her apart. She has a record to run on.
And so recently Bernie Sanders has kind of been on the offensive against Hillary Clinton. He said that she's not qualified because of all the money she gets from Wall Street and because she's, you know, supported things like the Iraq War. And she says one of her mentors is Henry Kissinger, one of her close friends who's, you know, has got a lot of blood in his hands from Vietnam and Cambodia. How do you respond to arguments like that?
I think it's petty. Hillary Clinton has been in public office for so long, you know. There are some issues that I may or may not agree with her, but overall, you know, we have a two-party system. She represents a lot of things that I stand for. I do not think it's helpful for Sanders to call her unqualified. She's the front runner. She's likely going to be the Democratic nominee. And if Sanders is really concerned about, you know, keeping the progress that we've made under Obama, he wouldn't be attacking her like that.
Pay equity, number one. I represent a union that's probably 58 to 60% women. So the pay equity issues are particularly important to us. But even more than that, the fight to increase the minimum wage, which is very important. Earned sick leave legislation, which we just saw go down in Annapolis. The senator is in favor of that, and so we're standing with her because she has stood with us on the issues that matter.
I was just at a conference in Chicago called Labor Notes, and there was some, I guess, rank and file disagreement with how some of the endorsements came down. People were saying that in unions where the process was democratic, the result was an endorsement of Sanders. How do you respond to that?
Well, I mean, I can only speak to our process, and I know that in our union, you know, we had a process where the rank and file voted and that recommendation was passed up through the executive board to the international executive board. I represent a constituency that voted probably 70% for Hillary in our process, so I can't speak for other unions' processes, but I can tell you that SEIU, one of the things we've done is we've built up such an energetic core that we couldn't afford to go against who our members wanted. We're standing with Hillary because our members first stood with Hillary. In many respects, the leadership are following the members.
And obviously the $15 minimum wage has been a big issue for SEIU. Hillary Clinton has only endorsed a $12 minimum wage. Bernie Sanders has endorsed a $15 minimum wage.
She's not all the way there yet, but we continue to work with her. We trust that she is going to be the best advocate on that issue. And, you know, we don't meet everyone initially where they are, but we're moving them in the right direction.
From Baltimore, this is Jess Lenore.